this is exactly the trap which Narad Muni is telling. These activities are condemned. Swabhava raktasya. Whose swabhava? Whose swabhava is to become attached to this material sense enjoyment? Itaraha janaha. Itaraha janaha. The people, the general mass of people, especially in this Kali Yuga, are not inclined. They want to enjoy their senses unrestrictedly, as much as possible. What is the problem? If I enjoy my senses, why this has to be condemned? This has to be condemned because Prabhupada is writing in the purport, the human beings, by long material association, life after life, have a natural inclination by practice to endeavor to nourish over material energy. Not in this life. Why I am saying there is no teaching required? Because it's a fact. You don't have to tell someone how to eat, how to sleep, how to mate, how to defend. Given a chance, we all want to eat more. More palatable, tasty food in the name of prasadam. We want to sleep more. We want to enjoy our senses. We want to have unrestricted sex life. We want to do that. There is no this thing. This is a natural thing. These are natural urges. This is because our long material association, life after life, that thing, that attraction for Vishaya is very strong. By practice, so the human beings, by long material association, life after life, have a natural inclination by practice to endeavor to lord it over material life. And they have no sense of the responsibility of human life. Fortunate situation. No sense of the responsibility of human life. Actually, if we are coming together, and the purpose of coming together in people's mind is also very different. Okay, maybe I just hear something, I get this thing. The real purpose of hearing, the real purpose of coming in Sadhu Sangha and discussing this Bhagavatam is develop a natural attraction, somehow natural. To come to that stage of natural, at least I should hear, I should allow this Krishna Katha, I should allow this Bhagavatam's message, I should allow this message of Bhagavad Gita to go inside my ears, so that the cleansing of my heart happens. Otherwise, this Indriya, the Vishaya, the attraction for Vishaya is very, very strong. Ar kave nitai chandir karuna habe, Vishaya vasana kave moro tuchha. We think we are chanting Hare Krishna, we don't have to, I don't have any problem. Not true at all. Ar kave nitai chandera karuna habe, vishaya vasana moro kave tuchha habe. To get rid of this vishaya's attachment, indriya's, indriya bhoga, is impossible, it's very difficult. That is why Prabhupada, actually, we should never leave the first and second cantos of Srimad Bhagavatam, because the first and second cantos were written by Prabhupada in Vrindavan before Prabhupada left for America. So he poured everything that he had in these two cantos. So these two cantos are very important, no doubt. I mean, the whole Srimad Bhagavatam is important. There is no difference. But even then, these two cantos we should again and again revise. If you have time, please go through the whole of Bhagavatam, chapter after chapter. But if you don't have time, at least these two cantos, one should just completely focus them, just absorb one's this thing. As we know that there are four verses of Bhagavad Gita which are called the Chatushloki, similarly there are four verses of Bhagavatam which are also called the Chatushloki Bhagavatam, 2.9.33 to 36, right? And these are called the seed giving verses or the essence of Bhagavatam. Just like the whole big tree, a big banyan tree or a big mango tree can come out from a small seed, the whole essence of Srimad Bhagavatam is there in this four seed verse. Just like how a mango comes out of a mango seed, every verse in the Bhagavatam is related to this four verse, and that is why they are called the seed verses. The first verse of the Chatushloki is Aham Eva Sam Eva Agre.